worship the Lord. Exalt His holy
name.
It is a wonderful thing to be in the house of the Lord. It is really a wonderful thing to be in His presence. You are worthy, Lord. Be worshipped, Lord. Take all the
glory.
This morning is you that we need. It's you that has our lives.
I
want to continue to honor the Holy Spirit. It is inevitable He's in this place. It's inevitable that He's in this place. Because the Scriptures teaches us that wherever He is, there is a difference. He is in this place. Pastor, thank you for keeping this grace. You will testify of what I'm saying. There are places that we go in and you struggle with the heavens. But here we are in the open heavens. Wherever you are watching us from, God is in this place. One thing that I know, it takes a price. It takes leaving aside everything to maintain what we are speaking about.
So my big bro, I salute you.
Mukuru wange, kusamwe chitiba. Thank you for standing. Thank you for holding to this grace.
Mama,
may God bless you. You've been worshipping and I've been seeing you. You have blessed me. The wife in you had been hidden for so long.
Wow.
You have people here. Amen. Pastor, may God bless you. I want to take this opportunity to thank for this opportunity that has been given to me to share the word of God in this place. May God count it for you. Thank you for believing in me. Wherever you are standing, stand firm. The scripture says in 1 Corinthians chapter 15 and verse 58.
1
Corinthians 15:58.
He
says, my dear brother, you should always be strong, not to lose heart. Continually being in the work of our Lord Jesus. For you know that you are not prevailing in vain. That's what I'm giving you. If God brought you to this place, whatever you are doing, you should not be shaken with what you're doing. Some of you, the stage where you are in, you are like a hen when seated on the eggs, when you are about to be to incubate. Let me repeat it. Some of you are like a hen. It has taken like 15 days. Sometimes the situation is not explainable. But God says, tarry. Serve your pastor. Serve this vision. Serve the anointing. The day will come when God unveils the person in you. The scriptures teach us, 1 Corinthians 2:9. What eyes have never seen, they have said the scripture. 1 Corinthians chapter 20 verse 9. What the eyes have never seen, what the eyes have never heard, which have never perceived in the heart of
God.
That's God has kept for those who love you. If you accepted Him as your Lord and Savior, and the Spirit of God brought you to such a place, your package is on the way. Just sit and be still. Your eyes are about to see. Your ears about to hear. As we heard the testimonies of the wedding, whom God has worked
for,
there are some people God is unveiling your chapters. God, Pastor has shown us the church. No one has ever told you. But you will come and you will be the one moving that church. Some God has kept you somewhere. He is going to introduce you somewhere. Look to your neighbor and tell your neighbor that Stephen, what God is boiling in your life is so heavy. There is something boiling great in your life. Your eyes that have never seen, what the ears have never heard, inside of you have never perceived. The Nazarenian has them for you. Though you are amazing, it will not hinder God to work. Praise the Lord. I honor God, for He loved us so much. Some of you are in this place. Let me repeat. You are like a hen. You are as if you are in one place. You are as if you are going nowhere. You are as if prayers are not being answered. But God knows what He's doing. After 21 days, that egg will not remain the way it is. It doesn't need a prophet to open
it.
It will come up and
show up.
Just stay in one place. Do whatever you feel. So your seed, serve with fear and tremble. When God introduces you, Pastor Yahweh Bujulis, I know him. He served Pastor Isaac with the fear and trembling.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. The world never knew what he was doing. He was like a hen on the edge. But you have not yet seen this egg. It is going to go so far. They have not yet understood. What has been born is so great. In our understanding, we cannot imagine. And the church you've seen will get filled. It will fill and demand more. Yes, though you are men, it's a vain belief, but I establish it. In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Just wait for me if you are together. Get your Bible. And we use the time we have. And we allow the Holy Spirit. I came with the ministers. I introduced first the one who was there. His brother Byamukama. He's the one leading the ushering team. And the other one is called Harriet Chomuhendo. She's an evangelist. And she's an intercessor. So I want to thank God. Brought me this place. In the morning, we spoke of a valuable thing. I want to speak how we stay up the power that is within us. But those that have not been with us, we might have left them behind. I know in my brother's place, I know he's a teacher. And you are following God. In the morning, we tackle on the word. We say the power of the Holy Spirit. And the many words have been spoken. But briefly, to those that have not been with us, I've been telling people that when God was creating us, we came from Him. That's how the Bible teaches. From Genesis 26 to 27. Genesis chapter 1, 26 and 27. And God said, let us make man in our image, in our own likeness. Amen.
So
we came from him. We have seen verse 28. He did not only create us. Inside of us, there is ability that he deposited in us. There is ability in us. Amen. When we went in chapter 3 of Genesis, we discovered that the destroyer, the one who's called Satan. He came and robbed the man of understanding. And he changed your mind not knowing what God deposited in you. What God did. For him he put on the flesh. And the reason of his coming to see that he takes us back in our original position. We thank God for Jesus. After saving us, it did not end there. Inside of us, there are many things. There are things that have to manifest as we are still on this earth. Those are not heavenly. We have to go to heaven when we have seen them on earth. There are men and women here. You have not yet understood what you are. Some of you are prophets. You are businesswoman. Some of you are teachers. Some of you are going to start an orphanage. You are going to do great things. But now they are not yet manifested. It doesn't mean you don't have them inside of you. What God does is to come and push the power and stirs up what is in you. Amen. I have seen Pastor's wife worshipping, and I remembered those
things
and said, God, your power exists. You can change and make someone whatever you want. Amen. And she's not yet. Where she's going is
5 years to come.
She's going to be a different woman. She's going to be a different woman. She's not only going to end here. We thank God for this machine. On the internet they have seen her. On YouTube she has been seen. But there are times coming when you will not end it. And you will even put your legs there. And they said here comes the lady. We thank God for Judith Babidi and the other worshippers. But God is coming up for you. You are going to be a sign which introduces the glory of God. Not by power, nor might. But Mrs. Pastor, I'm seeing in a vision the shoes you are putting on. I'm not talking of the one the spiritual shoes you are putting on. God is adding a level there. There is a sign of elevation. As a sign of elevation, God, when he calls his people, he confirms that he called them. He is near that you will not do. Who said that you will not make it? Who said you will not make it? So that we may enter into a great fountain. Briefly, let me explain a little bit. Then we go and pray. Within 10 minutes, I'm going to explain. In the 10 minutes, we are going to pray. Do you allow me to do this? Don't get tired of me. Even if you get tired of me, Pastor Yahweh loves me. Amen. We saw the word as we are speaking about the power of God.
Oh,
the power of the Holy Spirit. And we were saying that as Jesus was leaving the church, we saw the scripture in Luke 24:49. He said, don't leave the city until you are being filled with the power from above. He had spoken everything. But to tap into that authority, to bring up that capability, they needed the authority. They needed the ability. Amen. They needed the ability. Amen. And we saw scripture in Acts chapter 1 and verse
4.
And Jesus repeating the same word. Remember, the writer of the book of Luke is the same writer of the book of Acts.
Dr. Luca.
It was
Dr. Luke. And we see the introduction of that book is the same. We reached on verse 8. Acts chapter 1 and verse 8. That you are going to be filled with the power when the Spirit, the Holy Spirit comes upon you. And we will look into see how those what the meaning of those words. We are not speaking of the power that the prophets sell in the bottles. It's not the one we are talking about. We are not talking about these waters they sell. We are not talking about the hand. We are speaking of the abilities of God. The abilities of God, which He gives us to do His work, which enables us to do the things that we couldn't do. And we saw different definitions. And the first word that we had, and we were seeing verse 8, Chabade Chigambo Obuvum. When He said that you are going to be filled with power, and He was telling them that I'm going to give you courage so that you may attack each and every situation. What the power of God does when it comes in our lives, it enables you to go through downs and ups.
Amen.
Amen.
Twalabye chigambo courage.
We have seen a chigambo chine
chamber
is to confront the pain. Is the ability to do. And the ability to confront pain or opposition without fear. We saw the apostles and we continue to explain that after they were filled with the power, the Peter that we saw trembling on the little girl in Matthew 26:67. When the young girl was
telling
that Peter, you were with Jesus,
Peter
and Peter trembled and said, I don't know that man. And another one said so. Peter had not yet received the power of the Holy Spirit. When we enter in the Acts chapter 4, from verse 8. From verse 4 up to verse 10, you see this man Peter. This now is standing before the kings, standing before the priests, standing before the Pharisees and Sadducees. Those Sadducees, they were believing there is no resurrection, there is no angels, there is no demons. And Peter saying Jesus resurrected, and they were there being disturbed. And these Pharisees knew the laws, they were experts in laws. And they said there was a man who came in wearing a linen and was challenging them. And he had taken people away from them. And they had a grudge on him. Now we see Peter, after being filled with the power, he stands without fear. And he said, we were with the man. What do we learn? After being filled, there are things you are not going to get fear of. You have not understood. Even if you face the situation, you will confront it. And you say, no matter what comes, if Pastor Yahweh overcame, I'm also going to overcome because of the power of the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord. We saw the second one. What does it mean when He said that you will receive the power after the Holy Spirit comes upon you?
Insight.
We saw what it means, that it is the ability to see and to understand the truth to situations or to people. And we explained it with the scripture. Acts chapter 3. When Peter went into the synagogue in Acts chapter 3, as Peter was going to the temple with John, and they found a man on the entrance. This man needed food. But Peter connected. He connected himself.
Nagamba no.
And he said, no. This man doesn't need only food. He needs to walk. What do we learn as Christians? We find different situations. This power helps you. And you get the power to interpret as God sees you. There are people that have gone being despised. Even if you tell them that you are powerful, they don't believe it. Even if you tell them you are going to serve, they don't believe. So we need the power. So that they may break those curses. So that you may see yourself as God sees you. The man on the gate. God was tired of his begging. And he got Peter. And he put power on him. Wave if you are following. As we are running so fast. In the name of Jesus. What we saw next.
Confidence.
Obukakafu.
Amina.
Amen.
Twalabye bwe yagamba.
We saw when he said
timugenda kuwebwa amanyi
that you are going to be filled with the power. When the Holy Spirit comes upon you, he was telling them,
mugenda kufuna obukakafu mumwe.
You are going to get the confidence in you.
Bagamba, ngenda, ngenda kubera wamu na mwe.
He is saying, I'm going, but I'm going to be with you.
Kati nashika kasantia.
How will we confirm it?
Atogenda kubera wamu nange.
How are we going to confirm that you are with us? Do they connect?
Wanji.
It doesn't connect. In physically is living his, and he's saying, I'm with you. They needed something else to confirm, to see, to what they do that exceeds what they see. To see what they are looking at. Amen. Now we see the apostles. After being filled with power, they walk with that confidence. And even in prisons, they were confident. Even if they are being whipped, they were believing it. Even if they were opposing them, they believed it. There is a book that I read.
The Fox Book of Matters.
The men suffered for Christ. Before the kings like Nero, they could get Christians and put them in oil, boiling oil, and they could release them to the lions. But they were not fearing. And they are saying, you are burning the bodies, but there's someone who you are holding. Though you are walking barefooted on the streets of Kabao, you are not going to lose hope. You'll always have that confidence. In the rested house, you will kneel down and pray for the stone house. When you are single, you will not defile yourself. You will have that confidence in you. The one who said that he gives men is also my husband. But you are amen, discourages. You are near me, but I can't hear your amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Confidence.
Amen. Even if you have 20,000 and you are confident in you, God is going to work. Even if you don't have a single coin and you say, the one I believe is living, we saw a man David where he used to take care of the flock. That's where I got the Psalms. And he said, though I walk in the valley of shadow of death, I shall not fear, because he's with me. But yet he's surrounded with the bushes. I want you to get that confidence and faith. Look at your neighbor then, get that faith. Sometimes you move in the city and you see Muslims having faith in what they are doing. At their shops at noon, they believe the Allah is there. But yet the Christians are not confident that Jesus is with them. God is always with you wherever you are. Wherever you go, he is with you. Wherever you move, he is with you. I want you to get that proof in your heart. Whenever you face the wind, Isaiah 43, though you go through the fire with you, through deep waters, I'm with you, I'm not going to abandon you.
That's what Isaiah 43 says. What we saw next.
Multiplication.
When he said that you are going to be filled with power. After the Holy Spirit comes upon you. And he was saying that I'm putting something on you. Which is going to cause you to multiply. Your amen is so hard this
month.
And if you say amen to what? Say amen! Say amen for Jesus. Say amen while you're standing. Say amen. Turn to three people. Tell them I'm multiplying in anointing. The one who's sitting, don't bother about them. I'm multiplying in the name of Jesus. I take that anointing. The multiplication anointing. I'm being multiplied in the
world.
I'm being multiplied in my prayer life. I'm being multiplied financially. I'm being multiplied in connections. Move and tell someone I'm being multiplied. You have been so gentle. Move and tell someone I'm being multiplied. I'm being multiplied in my house, in my finances, in my church. I'm not going to be in a
separate.
I'm entering a new anointing. I'm entering a new anointing in the name of Jesus. Say amen if you believe it.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Multiplication.
That's why in our churches as Christians, that's how power. Today you find a church with two people. The next time you find it, they are 50. You find them, they are 200. So tell your neighbor that if you don't get settled, by the time you come, and the people around you will not recognize them, and they have taken the place, so tell your neighbor that be firm.
Amen.
Amen.
I receive that anointing of multiplication.
Let it be on you. So that you may start other businesses. So that you start other businesses. So that you get another land. That your children may multiply. So that you may produce even twins.
Hey!
Yay!
Amen.
Amen. Let us wind up with this.
Authority.
Obuyinza.
Authority.
Obuyinza.
Twalabi is the word, the ability to, the power to give orders.
Bwe busobozo bw'okuwa ebiragiro.
Amen.
Amen.
Kati bo tapping amu chisa chine chiko 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 bisamu.
When you tap in this grace of multiplication,
wait again, chintu echi commanding.
You need something that
no gamba kazigo gwen kuvam.
And you say, I'm leaving you, you the rented house, I'm leaving you now.
Utegera chengamba.
Amen.
No wewe chigambo mbuyinza.
And you get a word in authority.
Mupangisa toli mugabo gwange.
And you say, renting is not my share.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amina.
Amen.
Authority.
Obuyinza. When we are speaking of authority, it doesn't matter whether you are tall or small. Whether you don't have a car, you are going to understand what I'm saying. When you are walking on the Lord, you find the traffic. Even if the traffic officer is short like this basket. Even if he's short like this diary. But when he's putting on that traffic uniform, he has the authority to command the trailer. The short traffic person can command the trailer. So this authority doesn't determine on your education. You might be the first one to construct a house in your family. You might be the first one to travel nations in your family. I was the first one to get out of Uganda. Among the 9 children. I know what I'm speaking of. This one that the background doesn't decide this. When God does it, when God brings it, when God decides it, things just work smoothly. No one can stand before you. Just stand and say amen. Say I receive it. Say I receive it. Say I receive it. In the name of Jesus. God has called us and said they will come to you. You are not going to return to them. Not the online prayer, and even in the action. Amen. This is the time for you to speak up. And say 2022. At our place, I will go driving. You just command what you want to see in your family. You stand up and tell three people, if you don't believe it, me, I'm a sign at our house. I'm a sign in our family. Because of the power of the Holy Spirit. Because of the power of the Holy Spirit. Because of the authority of the Holy Spirit. Let me tell you, I don't know. At our place, there has never been a pastor. I was the first one. I called them on my wedding. And they said, God has answered us. And one of my aunts said, I was telling my mother, our clan has never gathered for such a joy. We only gather for burial. But yet God has done it. The power of the Holy Spirit. It doesn't do what has ever existed at your home. Let me repeat. It is not going to do what it has ever been. The Bible says it's doing a new thing. It's doing a new thing. When it comes in our life, it makes sure that your feet steps where you are.
Ay, 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 ay.
Rasik.